So, this claims to both resculpt and revolumize your face and your neck. And it better do a whole lot more than that for this price point. $69 for 50 mil. It is for very dry to dry combination oily and oily skin. So basically everybody. Sensitive is not in there. And one of the comments did say that somebody broke out in an acne. So this is probably not the best for people who have sensitive skin. In any case, the concept is kind of cool. You know, it's basically like two different products here and here, and they show you where to apply the product. So to revolumize, you use the purple stuff on your face, and to resculpt, you use the beige kind of stuff on your neck. I always think about these things like, if you want to resculpt, you have to do this before resculpting is actually necessary, because otherwise it's only surgery, Botox, and all that mess that is actually going to resculpt your face. That's why a lot of young people now are taking skincare very, very seriously, because if you start once your face is already sagging and all wrinkly and showing the signs of aging, which there's nothing wrong with that, count that as a blessing. But once your face starts doing those things though, it's kind of too late for all these creams. People still will buy it just to feel good about themselves, but probably not really gonna do much. Okay, so they say it's for all skin types, but they didn't point out sensitive skin, so I don't know. So yeah, it does all this morpho technology, whatever. So they show what it all is in there. Whoop, skirt. What did I see? Hyaluronic acid. Okay, now that is good. That is what we need. That is what we want. Hyaluronic acid is so good for retaining moisture in your skin. It's really a good product. If you see any product with hyaluronic acid, a girl, Jackie Aina here on YouTube, put me on to hyaluronic acid. It comes like Neutrogena, I know, has a whole line with hyaluronic acid, and it's so good. Makes your face feel like, sometimes we thought our face was dry, but it actually needed moisture. So sometimes when you feel your face is dry, you need to drink more, and you need to have products with hyaluronic acid, because that helps retain the moisture in your skin, helps your skin stay supple. So yeah, that's really good. Hyaluronic acid, whenever I see that, I'm cool with it. So how to use for multiple concerns: just put it, sculpt in the areas that you want to contour and tighten, and revolumize in those areas you'd like to plump and resurface, so basically face and neck. So yeah, hyaluronic acid, as I said. Ooh, this looks so juicy. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So now we're gonna try it out. Let's see what it actually feels. Let's get it. What's up, YouTube? What's cool? What's groovy? What's happening? It's time for life. So today I'm gonna try the Clinique Smart Clinical. The resculpt and revolumizing. This is my bare face. There's absolutely nothing on here. If you thought I bought that thing for $69, you are seriously mistaken. This is a tester, okay? We don't spend money like that out here. So I already tried this, apparently. So we're gonna resculpt. So this is what it looks like. See, this is how you do reviews on a budget. You don't have to buy every single thing that's out there to do a review. So that's what it looks like. I never take a lot of product because I don't know, I don't want to waste. So it's kind of thick jelly, and it's like that, very smooth. Smells rather horrible. It just smells like medicated or something. So anyway, I'm gonna resculpt my neck. Not that I need it yet, but you know, I already mentioned earlier on that you need to start early. You know, I saw that one of these things had yeast extract. I don't really quite know what that does. Go look it up. I'm gonna look it up after, but that's probably why it smells like, actually it's like yeast a little bit. So we're pushing up the way so that things don't sag down the way because of gravity. Our good friend gravity. You can just kind of massage. Not that I ever have time to do all these things anyway. And then there's this side. So it feels really good. Very thick. It almost feels like it's hugging your neck. Like, it feels like something really, like when I put my hand on it, it's like very warm actually. Almost like it's activating something. I don't know. So now we're going for this situation. It is kind of purple. That looks like that. That's a lot more, not as thick, and it smells pretty much the same. They don't make any mention of using it in combination with any other Clinique stuff, so I'm assuming this should be enough. But let me tell you, it doesn't smell that great. It smells a little bit like Aveeno, you know, that stuff that's made with wheat though, or something like that, or oats or something like that, because oats is very hydrating. I thought people used to do oats masks, you know, when YouTube was full of like all these homemade masks, and people were making masks themselves, and yeah, like with lemon, bicarbonate of soda, with egg, with bananas. And then when you were younger, you would try all these things out. But now everybody just goes out and buys all these high-end brands. And some of these influencers / YouTubers / Instagrammers, you wonder, like, where do you get the money from to start doing all this? Because they'll be reviewing this today and reviewing another very high-end brand tomorrow. Like, that's madness. I must say, it feels very good going on. That hyaluronic acid is definitely doing something. You just feel it going into the skin immediately. And I don't know if you can tell, but I think I'll look less ashy right about now. Let's see how it holds up. Maybe I'll come back and show you whether my skin became oily or whatever. I realized that before, I was not spending enough time like massaging it into my skin, massaging products into my skin, which probably caused the skin, you know, not to absorb the product that I was putting on. And so then it just sat on top of my skin like a layer, like a film, and then that eventually made my face look oily. But if you massage it in and there's nothing like really sitting on top of your skin, everything has gone into the layers of the skin, then you can let the product really seep in and really do its work. So that's about it. That's my 2 cents on this, that it's really good, but it doesn't smell very great. But you know, whatever you put on your face or even on your lips, whether it smells of watermelon or whatever you got going on, after a while the scent disappears anyway. So it's not a nasty scent. It just smells like wheat or yeast, but very mild, very very mild. It's not something you're gonna really smell. Even by doing that, you don't smell it anymore. So it just feels like your face, it actually feels like I've put about 5 different things on my face, because my skincare routine used to be about 5 to 10 different things on my face. It feels like I've done that, but it's just with this one thing. So if this is a one step, boom and done, I'm just wondering how long it's gonna last. 50 mil, it's quite a substantial amount. I'm assuming it will be around this, something like that. And then the cover itself will probably go up to here. So it's probably about this. And you have to remember that it's half and half. But it feels good. Not sticky, but you can feel that something's on there. I don't know how to explain it. But it makes your skin feel very supple and very smooth. So yeah, for now, I'm really liking it. I'm going to see how it is during the day. And then I will be back to share my thoughts and show you if I became oily or whatever. I'll try not to blot or do anything, just to show you what my face actually does naturally. So I'll be back. If you're already part of the family, make sure you hit bomb stomp and slam to the subscribe button. Comment because I want to know what you think. Like because you obviously liked this video and learned a lot. And I'll see you in the next one, which will be very soon. Make time for glorious life. It's time to start living it right. And I'll see you in the next one. God bless.